Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for tuning in yet again. Another powerful transmission of truth with no compromise lined up here in the next 3 hours. It is already Wednesday, the fifth day of February, 2014. And we are scheduled to be here for the next 3 hours live. Man, where to begin? The horror stories of cancer patients being turned away, little kids being kicked off their insurance, pre-existing conditions not being covered, workers getting their hours cut, people losing their jobs over Obamacare, Obama blaming it on the states. I've got a big stack of the ongoing chronicle that is Obamacare we're going to be breaking down, and the fact that the very same scammers that run the Democratic Party and control much of the Republican leadership are still acting like it's a great deal and it's weird to not like Obamacare and are trying to sell us the amnesty plan. That if you like what Obamacare is doing, you are going to L-O-V-E, love, love, love. It's not just legalizing the illegals that are here, who I'm not demonizing individually. On average, they're hardworking, good people, in my experience, on average. There's also a large criminal element because everybody from Latin America, mainly, that's running from, quote, justice, comes up here as well. So there's that big problem. But it doesn't matter. It's going to bring in another 30 million after that. And these people think the Democrats who give them welfare and all this to their buddies, they will vote to overthrow the country completely. And we're on the razor's edge of being able to turn back the globalist offensive. And that's why they're trying to get their entire agenda through right now. So we're going to be breaking all of that down and some of Obama's latest activities. Obama's climate hubs, I read the entire executive order establishing the Rural Affairs Commission 4 years ago that Homeland Security and the Pentagon jointly sit on the top of the organizational chart. In fact, will you guys print me the Rural Affairs Commission and Bureau that Obama set up, the executive order, and some articles about it, because I want to be able to show folks that. And Homeland Security and the Department of Defense, NORTHCOM, are over that. And I told you they're going to set up local spy bases in every city that are basically like farming threat fusion centers that, quote, will track environmental threats. And they're going to literally have their local Politico minions, commissars. Already Nature Conservancy, Sierra Club, and others have these, because I've experienced it with our ranch and with the local ranches in East Texas. And they'll send them in to identify things, to harass people, call in the EPA on farmers, you name it. Remember they tried to ban hay dust 4 years ago? They tried to ban 2 years ago children being able to do chores on the farm. This is the rural spy, CIA, NSA grid on record with drones. And so Watson, I was talking to Watson this morning. He was like, what do you think I ought to write about? Usually Watson comes up with his own research. But a lot of times, you know, I call up and give him ideas. And so I probably need to call Watson up. I said, I don't know what you should write about. I mean, there's so much going on. You could write about all the latest Obamacare stuff. We don't want to get Obamacare fatigue and just let them win and stop exposing how horrible it is. But now I realize we need to integrate in and talk about this, because it's an article about Obama launches climate hubs, that's what it's called, to help farmers and communities. Mm-hmm. And of course, Obamacare is meant to help you too, and shutting down all the power plants is meant to help you as well. Now, the goal is to bankrupt you and make you dependent, and they are targeting the country boy that can survive, as I've told you. In all the Pentagon drills, they train to literally machine gun people that look like your grandpa wearing John Deere hats.
The facts are in. The studies are legion. Sodium fluoride and other toxic members of the fluoride family are devastating the health and cognitive ability of the American people. So why are the social engineers adding it to the water? Simple. Dumb down the host population that the parasitic technocracy is feeding on. We may not have been able to get fluoride out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the exclusive InfoWars Life Fluoride Shield formula. Fusing six of the best documented ingredients from around the world to help the body remove not just toxic fluoride residues from the body, but a whole host of toxic substances. Let's take a stand against the globalist by blocking their poisons with Fluoride Shield. I use Fluoride Shield every day. Secure your Fluoride Shield and other pioneering formulations at InfoWarsLife.com today. Let's start cleansing our bodies now and support the InfoWar at the same time. That's InfoWarsLife.com. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com. In the last 50 years, iodine has been phased out of our staple foods and replaced with the halogen bromine, a practice now banned in nations around the world. Guess what else is in the halogen family? Fluoride. Ladies and gentlemen, Alex Jones here. In 1924, the federal government did the right thing and encouraged salt producers to add iodine. It's the good halogen on the periodic table. And the results are on record, reports documented, a 15-point IQ increase in areas that had previously been deficient in iodine. Bottom line, iodine is important. Unbound, clean, in a glycerin base, nascent iodine was the answer for myself and my family. You will find Survival Shield nascent iodine exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWars Life Survival Shield nascent iodine isn't just for emergencies. I take it every day. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Hi, I'm Janet Napolitano, Secretary of the Department of Homeland Security. Homeland Security begins with hometown security.
It seems apparent that our citizens are staying off the streets, which may make scarring particularly difficult, even with this year's rule changes. To recap those revisions, women are still worth 10 points more than men in all age brackets, but teenagers now rack up 40 points, and toddlers under 12 now rate a big 70 points.
This the is the new score, police state anyone, training manual video.
Over 75 years old has been upped to 100 points. As always, how fast you move determines how long you live.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's Alex Jones.
Come on, baby. Take a chance with me. I'm your live wire. Bring it up for a minute. Producing music like this nowadays. Maybe folks don't like it. Maybe I have bad taste. I'm alive. I'm running free. I'm live wire. Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. Need to be live wires, folks, and stop being slaves. Oh, best part right here. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the 5th day of February, 2014. We are transmitting worldwide. Sad story coming up, and we've got his lawyer, who's been doing a great job, in studio with us out in Bastrop, Texas, outside Austin. Months ago, there was a little scuffle going on. There was a bystander watching it. The video has now been released, finally, by the police. He was just standing there doing nothing, so the police tasered him in the back. Kind of like buck fever. Folks, you take deer hunting for the first time, will shoot a neighboring cow, or will shoot the first deer they see, even though it doesn't have antlers, or will shoot another person. That's what I see in a lot of these cop videos, where sometimes they'll just pull a gun out for no reason, not just a taser, and just shoot someone. And then, of course, try to grab all the surveillance tape, but then later surveillance tape will get leaked or somebody's hiding in the bushes videotaping it. There's been so many cases of that, like the famous case with the DART subways and train stations out in San Francisco, where they hear there's a fight on the bus, on the train. Nobody had been involved in a fight, it turned out. They grab the wrong group of people, put the guy in handcuffs, take a gun out, shoot him right in the back. Bullet goes through, bounces off the concrete, right back into his heart. So he got shot twice by the same bullet. And they go and grab everybody's cameras on tape. But somebody's in a train hiding, and the train pulls out and gets it all on tape. They filed the report saying he tried to take the gun from the officers. They had to take him out. And none of the cops got in trouble for lying. The cop that did the killing ended up getting 2 years in jail and served less than a year for just absolutely cold-bloodedly executing that man. And, of course, in the case of the homeless man that they beat to death, the son of a police officer, then got caught lying about that. They've now been found not guilty because the police said he might have had a pre-existing heart condition. That's right. Having his head and throat and legs and kidneys and everything stomped and beat in by 8 police officers had nothing to do with it. There are so many cases of that. There are just so many examples of this. It truly and absolutely boggles the mind on every front that these type of things are unfolding. And it shows the militarization of police that is getting more and more serious by the minute. Now, here is the Washington Post speaking of this, and then I'm going to shift gears into other news. And then get back into this in the next hour with the lawyer who's going to be in studio with us. But the Washington Post, scenes from a militarized America, Iowa family terrorized. And the Washington Post says we're in danger. Militarized police trained for the drug war are now being used for reported credit card fraud, where it turned out the people were innocent. And they come in the house and break their surveillance cameras and assault them, basically. And it's these images that really do terrorize the public. But they are meant to terrorize the public. They wear the black mask, the balaclava, all of it, for intimidation and for the projection of power. The problem with all of this is that the government, the criminal elements of the government, on record, ship in the majority of the narcotics. The big banks publicly launder almost all of the drug money, and police will tell you we're not allowed to investigate them. They are above the law. Now, obviously, the drug culture is where criminals already gravitate to, so there's a lot of bad people in it, a lot of criminals in it, because we've given them this black market. So I'm not endorsing the drug culture by any stretch of the imagination. I absolutely abhor it. My issue here is that they have now arrested a whole bunch of people in a raid on the actor Hoffman's death from heroin, a particularly strong type known as the Ace of Spades. They give these things brand names. And Hoffman reportedly was found dead, never even got the knee.